By the end of this video, you will learn exactly how you can stick to any habit, no matter how boring it is, no matter how many times you've tried it, no matter how many times you've failed it, and what's better, this even works for getting rid of bad habits. You see, about 6 or 7 months ago now, I was just your everyday teenager, addicted to dopamine. I'd watch YouTube nonstop, I'd play CSGO, gaming nonstop, and that's all my life would be. And I tried to do things like meditate or read books or eat healthily or start exercising, and I just couldn't do it. I didn't have the willpower to do it. But since I heard about Jerry Seinfeld's method to become a productivity king, I've been able to accomplish all of these habits plus so much more. See, back 6 or 7 months ago, just like Mel Robbins said, I found it so difficult to do the small things in life that I knew would benefit me.
One of the hardest things to figure out was, why is it so hard to do the little things that would improve my life?
And since I found this method that Jerry Seinfeld invented, who, if you don't know who he was, a great stand-up comedian, a director, a producer, and so much so that there's even a whole subreddit on Reddit about this method because it just works so well. And there's so many testimonials that I'm going to pop up now and now and now and now and now and now that just prove how well this method works. So let's get right into the video. So step one is you buy index cards, and there's a link for that in the description if you want it. So just click that link in the description, and that they're so cheap that you may as well buy them. They're also revision cards that are about that big, and yeah, you can use them for pretty much anything. And then step two is you draw 6 vertical lines, so there'll be 7 different columns, and then you want to draw 10, no, you want to draw 9 horizontal lines, so you end up with 70 different boxes. And why the number 70? Because it says that science has proven, and I'm going to pop up a study now, that on average it takes 66 days to keep a habit. So why not just round that up to 70, because you want to be a little bit more than the average. So step two is make an index card of 70 different little boxes. And now step three is you want to pick the habit that you want to stick with, or you want to get rid of a bad habit. For this example, I'm going to be using meditation because for me, it started to change my life. I've only been doing it for a couple weeks now, but already I can see the benefits. And meditation is one of those things that, as the book, The Willpower Instinct proves, as you do it, your willpower actually increases. So yeah, there's a few different disciplines that take a little bit of willpower to introduce into your life, but once you have the habit down, they increase your willpower. So it's a short-term cost for a long-term gain. So meditation is the example we're going to use in this video. And it's of vital importance that you start small and work your way up. The reason, one of the main reasons that you're failing all these habits that you've tried before is because you're starting too big. About a year ago, I decided it would be a good idea to start meditating for 30 minutes every day. And that just requires an amount of discipline that I just don't have. No, that's not what you want to be doing. You want to understand the benefits of having a long-term habit over the benefits of a short-term results. And there's a video up there if you want to understand this concept in more detail, but I'll explain it briefly for you. Basically, if you want to start a habit, you've got to start small, because by starting small and slowly working your way up, you'll have a long-term habit. You'll have the habit of meditating every day. Whereas if you start big, you might meditate for 30 minutes on the first day, you might meditate for 30 minutes on the second and the third day, but the fourth day, you'll be so drained, all this willpower will be exhausted, that you just won't bring yourself to be able to meditate. And so that means you've meditated 1.5 hours in the first 3 days, but then you've stopped the habit. Whereas if you start meditating 1 minute a day and you do that for a week, then you up it to 2 minutes. In the first week, you've only meditated 7 minutes, but you're on the way to forming a habit, and that is of so much more importance. So when you're picking your habit, start small. And I want you to stop the video right now and pick a habit that you want to implement in your life. Fitness, diet, meditating, exercise, whatever it is, just pick a habit right now and make sure you start small. Make it specific, measurable, actionable, and time. You must have a time limit for it. So yeah, do that right now. And if you're still confused about the whole concept of this, I'm going to get onto the magic trick that enables you to keep the habit easily just in a second. But before we get onto that, on the back of the card, you want to write a few reasons why you are keeping this habit. And the best way that I do it is I make a little mind map, because what this mind map does is it allows you to recognize the second and the third order consequences. And what this means is you write meditation or whatever your habit is in the center of your page, and you branch out the direct benefits of why you should start meditating. Maybe you'll be able to concentrate a little bit better. You'll see you'll be less all over the place. You'll be a little bit more focused. So that's the first thing. You write that across. Then you write the second, third, and fourth, and however many you can come up with. Then this is the important bit. From the first order consequence, which is you'll be able to focus a little bit more, you draw more lines coming out from them. So the benefits of being able to focus a little bit more, you'll be able to get more work done. And you do the same thing again. What are the benefits of getting more work done? Well, you're going to be more successful. You'll have more of an impact on people's lives. You'll be better off. You'll be wealthier, right? All of these benefits. And what that does is it connects the task of meditating every day with huge long-term results. And what this will do is it will make you feel motivated whenever you read it. When you're writing this out, don't just write things that you think you should be writing. Keep brainstorming until you actually feel motivated. You have to feel the motivation. You have to feel like you really want to nail this habit. Otherwise, it's just not going to work. And also, write, leave space for one or two lines at the bottom of the index card for a something that we're going to get onto a little bit later in the video. So yeah, keep mind mapping until you're excited, till you really want to keep the habit. You've got to feel this. And the next step is you've got to start today. That's right. You've got to start doing the habit today. No matter what it is, no matter what excuses you're now coming up with, you have to do it today. And I know right now you're coming up with rationalizations. No, I can't do this. It's too late. I want to get to bed. Or no, because I'm not close to where it is, or whatever the case may be. If it's possible for you to do it today, then do it today. And now for the magic trick. And this is what makes the whole thing work. Are you ready? Yeah. You might have guessed it already, but you draw a huge cross once you've done the activity. And take pleasure in writing that cross. Make yourself proud of yourself. Once you've written the cross, dwell on it for 30 seconds and make yourself feel amazing, because you are on the road to making this a habit. You are on the road to building discipline. You are on the road to crushing your goals. Every cross you take is one step closer to crushing your goals. You've got to feel, congratulate yourself. You've got to feel it in your body, because if you don't, it's going to make it so much more difficult to keep the habit. So yeah, dwell on it once you've made the cross and feel how happy and proud that you are, that you're making your dreams happen. And now, the next step, you've got it. Day two, do the same thing again and draw the cross. A big, satisfying cross. And again, dwell on it. Congratulate yourself. You're now two steps closer to your dreams. And this goes on and on and on until you get to day 70. And at that point, the habit is yours. It will no longer take any willpower to keep the habit. It will be easy to maintain the habit, and you'll still reap the benefits. I've already said, a short-term investment for a long-term gain. But it's not as easy as it sounds. So what do you do if one day it's got to 11:50 and you haven't done your habit? What do you do? Well, you turn over your card and you'll read your why. Don't leave this card until you've felt the emotion, until you feel like you've got to do it. And that way, you're so much more likely to do it. There's been so many times where I haven't felt like doing something. I've read the back of the Y card and it's motivated me, and I've gone and I've crushed that X. Oh no, what happens if you miss a day? Well, you remember earlier I said that when you've drawn your mind map, you leave space, a little bit of space at the bottom. Here's what you write at the bottom of that card. You write a little contract to yourself. Write, I will stick to this every single day. And you write that down. Literally, when you write it down and you sign it, magical things happen. But that's not all that you write. You write, I promise to myself that I will get back on the habit if I miss a day. You should never have more than one blank day next to each other. You make that promise to yourself. And when you do that, you will stick to the habit. It's just that little bit of extra motivation when you miss the day, because it's the last thing you want to miss the day, then miss another day, then miss another day, then miss another day. That is what we want to avoid. So you write the little disclaimer to yourself. And if you want, here's a little advanced tip, you can write a punishment for yourself. Yes, it's okay to self-punish, as long as don't be physical and don't dwell on it. But for a little bit of time, let yourself self-punish. For example, you could be to donate some money to a football club that you hate. Make yourself do that if you don't stick to the habit. Say you're going to donate money to me. Yeah, good idea. Donate some money to me. I'm joking, I don't want your donations. Also, by the way, quick disclaimer, you might notice that I don't have any ads on these videos. I'm not about that. Your time is precious and I'm not going to waste that, but I'm getting distracted. So yeah, that's it. That's the method that got me to build daily habits in my life that's completely changed my life. If you're new around here, then subscribe. But the last point I want to make is I want to emphasize to you how important it is to start small. Don't be cocky. Start really small. Think how small you're thinking now, then half it. And if that's so, so easy, then yeah, go back to the original size the next day. Only improve at a trajectory that you're 100% confident that you'll be able to stick to the habit. Let me repeat that. Only improve at a trajectory that you're 100% confident that you'll be able to stick to the habit. Don't go too fast because you're going to fail. What's more important is the long-term habit. But that's it from me, guys. Remember to subscribe, but I'll see you tomorrow.